Hello everyone, welcome to a new episode of Let's Play Forge. So, let us begin. Okay. I have won the coin toss, so I get to choose if I go first or if I go second. I'm gonna go first, just because that's what I usually do. So, am I satisfied with my current hand or do I want to mulligan? I guess I'm satisfied. Keep. Okay, let's place down a swamp and let's begin. End turn. He places down an island. Then it's my turn again. I place down a mountain. Nothing much I can do with my current hand. End turn. Places down his own mountain. Now I'm gonna place down a plains card and I'm going to summon Minotaur Sure Shot. End turn. He places down his own mountain and then he taps everything to summon Aerial Guide, which is a 2/2 Drake creature, which has flying, and whenever Aerial Guide attacks, another target attacking creature gains flying until end of turn. So that's annoying. But thankfully I've got Minotaur Sure Shot has reach, so I can use that to my advantage. Let's place down another mountain card. And let's summon Kenros Scrapper. Now I'm not going to attack with Minotaur Sure Shot because he has reach, and because he has reach, he will be the only creature capable of blocking Aerial Guide, because Aerial Guide has flying. So I don't want to attack with Minotaur Sure Shot because I don't want to tap him. I need to have him untapped so that he can block during my opponent's next turn. And I cannot attack with Kenra Scrapper because I just summoned it this turn and it has summoning signals. So for now I won't attack with anything. I'll just end my turn. He will summon another Aerial Guide, which really sucks. I will be putting down more mountains. I think I have enough to summon Horror of the Broken Land, so might as well do that. Okay, so now we have three creatures on my side of the field. So let's attack with Kenna Scrapper. I will exert it to get four power for the remainder of this turn. So I did some damage to him. He casts Final Reward to remove my Horror of the Broken Lands from the field. That's annoying. But it doesn't really matter because now I got another Horror of the Broken Fields. So I will summon that as well. Now Kenra Scrapper is already tapped due to exerting it last turn, so I cannot use this. So, I can attack him with Minotaur Sure Shot, but again, I don't want to tap it because it can block Aerial Guide. Horror of the Broken Lands will not be able to block any Aerial Guide because it doesn't have neither flying nor reach. So, let's move on. He summons Manticore Eternal, which he has as a condition that Manticore Eternal attacks each combat if able. So he will attack me with this next turn once its summoning signals is removed. So I will need to be able to block that. Now, what can I summon? I can summon Inferno Titan. But I can also summon a Desert Cerodon. Now, I think I want to summon Inferno Titan. And now since Inferno Titan gets summoned, I can do free damage distributed to any order that I want. So I'll do 2 damage to one of his aerial guides and 1 damage to him. Okay. Yeah, so 2 damage to aerial guide to kill it and 1 damage to the player itself, Nicole Bolas. So one of his aerial guides is dead. He has another one though, so that's annoying. So one of them needs to be blocked with Minotaur Sure Shot, Manticore Eternal will be blocked with, I guess, Horror of the Broken Lands or Inferno Titan. I guess I would rather choose Inferno Titan because Inferno Titan would be able to block it without dying, whereas Horror of the Broken Lands, if it were to block Manticore Eternal, it would die from the attack. So yeah, I'll probably do that, but first let's attack him with Kenra Scrapper. Actually, do I want to attack him with Kenra Scrapple? If I exert it, yes I do. Let's exert it. Yeah, he did damage. So, just because he kind of has to, due to the card's condition, he will attack me with Manticore Eternal. And I will block him with Inferno Titan, because Inferno Titan is strong enough to resist his attack and not die from it. So let's use that. Excellent. Now he summoned Wasp of the Bitter End and the Marauding Bone Slasher. Okay. Let's put down another swamp and let's summon Desert Cerodon. We're in a very strong position right now. We've got a bunch of really strong creatures on the field. So again, I will not attack with Minotaur Sureshot just because he has flying creatures that are ready to attack. So I want to be able to defend myself against them. So instead, I will be attacking with Inferno Titan and with Horror of the Broken Lands. Because Inferno Titan attacks, I have to select how I do free damage distributed to whichever I want. I will do 2 damage to his aerial guy to destroy it, and 1 damage to Wasp of the Bitter End to destroy it. Like this. So both his flying creatures are now dead. So I guess in hindsight I should have attacked with Minotaur Sureshot now because there are no more flying creatures that I need to be afraid of. But oh well, too little too late. Now he's only at 1 life. He has to do something amazing this turn to prevent himself from losing this battle. He summons Nicol Bolas the Deceiver. And I don't know how much that's going to help him. I'm going to just Alpha Strike him so that all the creatures I have untapped on the field will attack him simultaneously. I don't think he has anything to defend himself with, so let's just attack him. Yeah, and he died. It's already too late. So he lost Zealot of the God Pharaoh. Okay, next match. Since I won the last battle, I will be going second. I will actually, do I want to keep my hand? This is a really terrible hand because I don't have enough lands in it to generate mana. So let's mulligan instead. Yeah, this is a better hand, I would say. Return 1 card to the bottom of your library. Well, sure, let's go with without weakness, I guess. Okay. Do I want to keep my hand? Yes, I want to keep my hand. So he goes first, like I said, and I go second. I'll put down a Desert of the Glorified. Play land and turn. Excellent. Now I'm gonna put down a Plains card and turn. He summons Eternal of Harsh Truths. So let's make sure he won't be able to use that to its full potential. I'm going to summon Kenra Scrapper to be able to block Eternal of Harsh Truths if he were to attack me with it. And now he used Open Fire to destroy my Kenra Scrapper. Okay. So he uses Eternal of Harsh Truths to attack me, and because he attacks me and I've got nothing to block him with, he will draw a card as per the Eternal of Harsh Truths description on its card. So that was annoying. Let's put down a swamp. Let's summon another Kenra Scrapper. End turn. He's going to attack me again. I will block it with Kenra Scrapper. So one power from Eternal of Harsh Truths against free life on Kenra Scrapper means that Kenra Scrapper will survive its attack, and two power from Kenra Scrapper or as against free life of Eternal of Harsh Truths mean that Eternal of Harsh Truths will also survive. So Kenra Scrapper will just block it, but neither creature will die. But since Eternal of Harsh Truths had Afflict 2, I still lost 2 life even though I blocked the attack. So that's annoying. Let's see what we can do about this. So I finally have enough mana to summon Manticore Eternal. So let's summon it. And I will be. Actually, no, I won't be attacking with Kenra Scrapper. Let's leave everything untapped. So he used Final Reward to remove my Manticore from the field. So he's really using his spell cards right now, which really sucks. I need one more mana to summon Inferno Titan. I don't have enough mana to do it just yet. So let's instead summon. Can I summon Desert Cerodon? I cannot. I don't have enough mana for that either. I have enough mana for Horror of the Broken Lands, though. So let's go with that instead. Man, the lack of mana is really troubling me right now. So he's attacking me with Zealot of the God Pharaoh. I'm gonna block him with Horror of the Broken Lands. Four power from the Zealot of the God Pharaoh against four life of Horror of the Broken Lands means that Horror of the Broken Lands will die after the damage calculation. But four power from Horror of the Broken Lands against three life of Zealot of the God Pharaoh means that Zealot of the God Pharaoh will also die at the end of the damage calculation. So both creatures will destroy each other, which is unfortunate, but it is how it is. Instead, I will replace Horror of the Broken Lands with Gilded Cerodon, since Horror of the Broken Lands was killed by him. And now I'm going to attack him with Kenra Scrapper. I will exert Kenra Scrapper. Excellent. So he summoned Aerial Guide and Burning Fist Minotaur. Kinda sucks. So let's see how we're going to deal with that. I'm going to. Since I don't have any creature on the field that has flying nor reach, I will use Torment of Venom to destroy his aerial guide so that he will not be able to attack me with it. Yeah, that should work. And now he also sacrificed another creature, so all that he has left is a Burning Minotaur. Now I can attack him with Gilded Cicerodon, but if I were to do that, Gilded Cicerodon would become tapped during his next turn. And I would not be able to block him if he were to choose to attack me with Burning Fist Minotaur. So instead, I will not attack him. I will just end my turn. He still decides to attack me for some reason. So I will block him. I think that was a bad move on his side. I don't know what he was thinking. Lay down a mountain card and I can finally summon Inferno Titan. Okay, since Inferno Titan got summoned, I get to choose free damage to be distributed however I want. I will apply all free damage against his Marauding Bone Slasher to destroy it. And now I can just Alpha Strike him with everything I've got. I will exert Kenra Scrapper so that he will do 4 damage. Apply these effects randomly. And Gilded Cerodon wants me to select a creature that will not be able to block during this turn. I don't think it matters. Since my opponent doesn't have any creature, I will choose one of my own creatures. This effect doesn't matter at all, really. So it's not really important. It's his turn. He summons a Kenra Eternal. I think he's toast. Basically, I just think he's toast. Let's just attack him with... yeah, I will attack him with... I will use Onward to double Inferno Titan's power from 6 to 12 so that I can destroy him in one fell swoop. And now I'm going to attack him. I actually just with Inferno Titan, that should be enough to kill him. So Inferno Titan is attacking. Because of this, I need to choose how the free damage he creates gets distributed. I will choose 2 damage to be distributed to Kenra Eternal to kill it, and 1 damage to be distributed to my opponent itself. So 2 to Kenra Eternal to kill it. So Kenra Eternal is dead, it can't block Inferno Titan anymore, and now Inferno Titan's attack will go through. Since Inferno Titan has 12 damage because of me applying Onward on it, I will be able to kill him since he only has 9 life left. So let's do that. And I won. And now I get to choose the booster set from which I win my cards. Let's go with a card from Hour of Devastation. So, I get another Manticore Eternal. And I also get Leave/Chance. Leave is an instant that costs 1 light mana and 1 other mana, and which does return any number of target permanents you own to your hand. I don't see where that would be useful, but okay. And the chance effect, which is which is flipped horizontally, costs 1 red mana and 3 other mana, and is a sorcery, so I can only cast this during my turn, during the main phases. And what it does is that it's an aftermath effect, so I can only cast this once this card is already in the graveyard. And what it does is that it allows me to discard any number of cards, then draw that many cards. That's useful. And then I get As Foretold, which costs 1 blue mana and 2 other mana, and is an enchantment, and which does, at the beginning of your upkeep, put a time counter on As Foretold. Once each turn, you pay 0 rather than pay the mana cost for a spell you cast with converted mana cost X or less, where X is the number of time counters on As Foretold. So the more As Foretold is on the field, the longer it's on the field, the more powerful it gets, and the more powerful spells I get to cast without paying for them. So that's awesome. But it's only one single spell card for each turn. So it's got limited use, but it's still pretty nice. And finally, Scavenger Grounds, which is a desert land, and for which by tapping I add 1, I guess that's white mana? Oh no, it's not white mana. I think that's colorless mana. Add 1 colorless mana to your mana pool. Or for 2 mana, when tapping, I can sacrifice a desert. And for that, I get to exile all cards from all graveyards. That's not that great, honestly. Out of all of these, I guess As Foretold is the best card from its effects. Anyways, this has been a fun game. Thank you for watching.